Every year, the biggest biomass migration on the planet happens on the coast of South Africa. Billions of sardines undergo a mystery migration. And predators are drawn from all corners of the ocean. The Greatest Feast team aims to film all of them. Just as the Sardine Run begins, they check in at predator colonies. First up, the 4,000 Cape fur seals that are preparing to meet the fish.
Early morning and the seals are waking up. We got the bulls, the pups that are born in November. We got the females that are still playing around.
Conditions are absolutely beautiful. So it's a good start, looking good.
As the seals mobilize, Cape gannets take to the skies. But getting to the colony isn't easy.
This is the treacherous pier. This is where we're going to be staying for the next few days. I think this was built many years ago. Can't actually film. So much flipping dust. I have to actually keep my eye to the viewfinder. Otherwise, yeah, you can't see anymore.
It's noisy and smelly.
It's just a visual extravaganza. I can't believe what you're seeing. Thousands of birds. It's one of my favorite places in the world.
The crew time it just right. Hungry seals are here to feed on baby gannets. An unexpected twist to the sardine story. Then, the wild coast awaits. This is the arena in which the run will play out. Will the shoals make it this far? No one knows.
Have you seen any animal activity this morning?
Very, very quiet the whole coast.
Then, good news comes in. Shoals have been spotted. It's been weeks of waiting and preparation, but it looks like Mother Nature is on their side.
We get up at least an hour and a half before sunrise, still dark. We prep the gear, we make sure all the gear is working.
Sun is rising, and the shot over is turning.
Two crews and a technology for every scenario.
A lot of the gear has gotten smaller. In the past, underwater housings and rigs and systems were absolutely gigantic. These days, they've been consolidated down. We seem to have more toys now, but it's also pretty amazing that we've got all the bits and pieces that we need to be able to document whatever situation as accurately as possible, whether that being having shot overs, underwater red systems, or drones. You know, in this day and age, it's pretty amazing that we can deploy whatever the right camera is in the right situation.
Having the shot over, which stabilizes the horizon and gives you those stable shots even when the sea is on its head.
Finally, the mother load arrives. so do the predators.
Communicating with the skipper is vital on one of these shoots, especially when shooting topside, because you want to be where the best light is. Eventually, the skipper gets to know what you want, and he puts you in position like that.
The biggest challenge, really, over these periods is just having the stamina to keep going for long periods of time. It's obviously long, long days at sea, long, long hours. Conditions are cold. But also the incentive is there because you know that it's going to be cooking out to sea and we're all pretty excited to get out there and spend our time there.
Just as things hot up, an unexpected visitor arrives.
The Brutus whales are really, really sneaky. You need eyes in the back of your head here. Slipped into the water, and as I went in, the big male sort of turned and came straight towards the boat, and then he dipped down, and that dorsal fin is like 6 foot, and you pop your eyes up and you just see it going down into the water in front of you, and yeah, you also at that point you realize how small fish you are in the sea and how vulnerable you are. But also it's like excitement, I guess. Your adrenaline's pumping, you're one-on-one with the ocean's probably apex predator.
The orcas then hunt a dolphin right in front of the boat.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Right, here we go.
I got that.
Yeah,
you get it, come on.
I'm gonna look now.
Female just came out of the water at full speed, hit the dolphin like this. It came flying across frame, hit the water. I wasn't even watching the camera. I stopped the record button and I just hoped that I got it. And then I was literally like, there's just adrenaline. I was shaking. I looked at the other guys, you know, and we all just started to like erupt. We were just going, yeah! You know, like it was one of the most amazing wildlife thing spectacles I've ever seen.
We got some lovely surprises, you know, huge pods of common dolphins. Orcas. We got gannets. So, yeah, we got a lot of what we were looking for.
The sardines take the gap and escape into the blue. Until the feast brings everyone together again next year.